So another one bites the dust with Philippe Coutinho leaving for Barcelona. With the likes of Harry Kane and Eden Hazard linked with a move to Spain, is the Premier League now just a hunting ground for the big two in La Liga? Let's take a look at some of the Premier League's best players who've left for Spain since 2003. 2003, David Beckham. Who would have thought that getting a football boot chucked at your head would result in you getting a big move to Real Madrid? Back in 2003, when David Beckham's celebrity was engulfing Old Trafford, Sir Alex Ferguson had begun to grow weary of his number 7 constantly appearing on every Hello magazine, and after some dressing room dust-ups, the England captain was punished with a blockbuster £24 million move to Spain. To be fair, I think being forced to live with that hairstyle for more than 10 minutes was punishment enough. Despite never actually wanting to leave Manchester, he fought back the tears and battled on like a martyr, picking up a 10 but little else, just the one title in 4 seasons, before deciding to move into the semi-retirement home that was the MLS, or as Jose Altidore likes to call it, his level. 2004 at Michael Owen. Think of this as the moment when Michael Owen's career nosedived into a pit of despair consisting of benches, knee injuries and terrible career decisions. At just 24 years of age, Owen was unveiled at the Santiago Bernabeu, but not before Los Blancos made a move for Milan Baros. Euro 2004 was a weird tournament, don't ask. In an £8 million deal with the unforgettably forgettable Antonio Nunes, who sounds like that Mexican fella in the goal franchise, going the other way. Owen spent one unhappy year in Madrid. Fair enough, he got to play with some of the best players in the world and even got on the score sheet in El Clasico, but he was stuck on the bench most of the time and wouldn't play Champions League football for another 5 years. And even then, he had to make a deal with the devil to do so. 2005, Thomas Gravesen. Alright, don't laugh. Yes, putting Thomas Gravesen at a club like Real Madrid makes about as much sense as Paul McShane actually making a living from this profession, but he was actually a good player for Everton and definitely a big loss when he left. The Dane left Everton in January 2005, midway through their unlikely surge for the top four, with Marcus Bent up front. I think it's fair to say the league was a lot easier back then. The £2.5 million signing, couch change for Real Madrid, was sparingly used until he was eventually forgotten about. 2006, Ruud van Nistelrooy. With 150 goals for United, van Nistelrooy's time came crashing to a muddy halt, having been omitted from their Carling Cup final win over Wigan. The £15 million signing duly scored 64 in 96 games for Madrid. Not bad. 2007, Thierry Henry. It's a shame Arsenal Fan TV didn't exist 10 years ago, because you would love to have seen some of the reactions to the news that the fee received for a club legend and record goal scorer Thierry Henry was going to be £500,000 less than the one Charlton were receiving for Darren Bent. It'd mean 2 years since Arsenal won anything, and for Henry that was long enough. Realising that trophies and Nicholas Bentner do not go hand in hand, he made for the exit and signed for Barcelona for an astonishingly low fee of £16 million. 2008, Alexander Taleb. Another Arsenal hero, another Barcelona signing. The Catalans seem to do their shopping at Anfield these days. They could just save themselves time and go straight to the factory. But about 5 to 10 years ago, it was the Emirates which they bled dry. It was July 2008. Alexander Taleb was one of the best playmakers in Europe, and at the age of 27 had the world at his feet. Within 3 years, his teammates would be Steven Carr and Cameron Jerome. Since that £15 million move, his confidence seemed to shatter. He barely got a look in at the new camp and has since moved clubs 11 times as he's fought to get his career back on track. He really should have just stayed put. 2009, Cristiano Ronaldo. This was arguably the transfer that swung the pendulum of power over to Spain. Marketed as the best league in the world, here was Manchester United, the country's most successful representative, being forced to wave goodbye to their best player, powerless to do anything other than command what was then a ridiculously steep £80 million fee from Real Madrid. It's 9 years later, and Liverpool have just spent £5 million less on a defender from Southampton. Good lord. 2010, Javier Mascherano. Javier Mascherano is just one of the former Liverpool contingent at the Nou Camp, having signed for Barcelona in August 2010 for €24 million. Despite a patchy start, he's gone on to win 4 league titles, 2 Champions Leagues and 4 Copa del Reyes. Not bad for a lad who was once kept out of the team by Hayden Mullins. 2011, Cesc Fabregas. When Cesc Fabregas returned home to Barcelona in 2011 for £35 million, it was easy to forget he was still only 24, considering how young he was when he'd broken into the Gunners' first team. Oh, well, that's a bit awkward. 2012, Luka Modric. Luka Modric spent most of 2011 desperately trying to get his move from Tottenham to Chelsea. The Croatian playmaker was probably pretty annoyed at the time, but I'd say he's over the moon now, considering a year later he was a Real Madrid player in a £30 million deal. The midfielder, who was once turned out by Newcastle in favour of Ignacio Gonzalez, was initially voted worst signing of the season, but has since settled and has 3 Champions League medals. 2013, Gareth Bale. As if robbing Tottenham of their best player in 2012 wasn't bad enough, Madrid decided to do the exact same thing the following summer. Gareth Bale had finally come of age, hitting more than 20 goals in a season for the first time in his career, and was rewarded with a world record £85 million transfer to Spain. So, bad news Tottenham, they know where you live. 2014, Luis Suarez. I think it tells you how badly Barcelona wanted Luis Suarez that they still went ahead and signed him from Liverpool for £75 million, despite the fact he just decided to have his lunch on Chiellini's shoulder during the World Cup in front of millions, leading to a lengthy ban. 132 goals and 170 games later, I think it was a good decision, though. The decision to sign him, that is, not the cannibalism. 2015, Steven Nzonzi. You would have thought Real Madrid, the biggest club in the world, with all the resources at their disposal, could have afforded to fork out on a fax machine that actually works. Because they didn't, David Gea doesn't make this list. Instead, we'll put Steven Nzonzi Zanzi, and the first entry that didn't end up at either Barca or Madrid. Yes, there are other clubs in Spain. Signed for £7 million by Sevilla in July 2015, he was a big loss for Mark Hughes Stoke City. 2016, Samir Nasri. Alright, I'm not going to sit here and pretend that Samir Nasri was a Premier League star. I have a drawer full of dirty socks that would have seen about as much action for Man City this season as he would. 2016 was the year La Liga left England alone, so I'm just going to have to include Nasri. He ended up at Sevilla on loan. 2017, Diego Costa. Yes, it's true, Diego Costa was effectively dumped over the phone by his manager, but there's no doubting Costa was one of the best strikers in England. 22 goals last season as they romped to the league title. He's back in Spain now with Atletico, and in typical Costa fashion, scored and was sent off on his first start back. That lad needs to stop eating the blue Smarties. 2018, Philippe Coutinho. 2018 is only a week old, but the Premier League has already lost one of its best to Spain. Philippe Coutinho off to strut his stuff at Barcelona in a deal worth £142 million to Liverpool. Best of luck replacing him, Jurgen, because I don't think Danny Ings is the answer.